fine house on old Cape Cod is every sailor's dream. A good brick hearth and chandeliers are hanging from the beams. A split shake roof, a weather vane to catch the ocean breeze. A platform called the Widow's Walk for gazing out to sea. Bill Johnson was a Chatham lad, an orphan, so we're told. He first shipped out a cabin boy when only 12 years old. A few years on the ocean put the young man to the test. He hauled the sails and cursed and climbed the rigging with the best. And Nancy was daughter of a lobster man, they say. She met this handsome sailor on the shores of Buzzard's Bay. That night they lay together as close as two can be, loving to the rhythm of the breakers by the sea. Next day the sailor asked her to become his lawful wife. They strolled the beach together and planned a happy life. Someday I'll be the captain of the finest ship at sea. We'll build a big house on the Cape and raise a family. A few days on the mainland and a woman's love is sweet, but Bill was keen to feel the ocean swell beneath his feet. He wed his darling Nancy on a brig from Baltimore, set out to sea and left her in a cottage on the shore. It's all off to Jamaica for the Indies' finest rum, and on across to London, loading dry goods by the ton. From Zanzibar to Singapore for spices, silks, and tea, the makings of a fortune for the good ship's company. Bill sailed the seas while Nancy stayed at home, mending sails and raising up three children all alone. Still dreaming of the big house on the Cape's good solid ground, while Bill became a second mate and sailed the world around. Then Bill was made the captain of a clipper ship so new, a proud man you've never seen, his dreams are coming true. He hired a good ship's carpenter and a dozen hardy men, and sent the word to Nancy saying, let the work begin. The captain's house is finished on the day the ship set sail. She's bound for California, everybody wished her well. He bid farewell to Nancy, keep the home fires burning bright, then look for me November sailing around the Chatham Light. Her flew southward till she came around the horn. 'Twas there she met disaster in an awful winter storm. A wild and fierce sou'wester sent the mainsail crashing down. The ice away swept o'er the decks and all the crew were drowned. Gray skies of November brought a dismal, chilling rain. They scanned the broad horizons for the ship that never came. Now Bill, he lies forever in a grave so cold and deep, while Nancy walks the widow's walk and gazes out to sea.